Hello and welcome back, G-Man in the studio lab. Today I am giving you the full calibration procedure on my KVP. If you want to know what the KVP is, you can refer back to my other videos that I have made on it. Today I am just going to show you how to calibrate it. First, a few tips on what to do. Let the KVP warm up a few minutes. It's an analog module, so it needs about 5 minutes, should be plenty of time. And remember, do not touch it with your hand during calibration. You may be tempted to hook it up to a loose cable and hold it in your hand while you're calibrating it. Well, I would advise not to do that, because touching the module causes severe drift by even a semitone or two. Go ahead and mount it in your rack. That's the best way to calibrate these things. At this time, I would like to mention the trimmers on the back. This design for the KVP comes directly from the Korg MS-02, and the MS-02 had these trimmers. And in my experience, the trimmers are only necessary to compensate for when the transistor pairs are not well matched. Well, on these modules that I'm making, these transistors are very, very well matched. So I have found these trimmers to really be unnecessary. I set these to dead center, 12 o'clock on all of them, and I just leave them there. I've never had to mess with those, and it's never impacted my calibration. In future revisions, I may be getting rid of these and replacing them with just straight resistor pairs. I will be using the Keystep Pro to send the pitch CV signal to the KVP. One thing you will want to do in the global settings, I set the CV base note to C-2. On my Keystep Pro, I am also using -1 octave. And then I will be using the low note, 1, 2, 3 octaves, and then the high note. Just keep in mind, this is a 3-octave keyboard. My MS-20 is a 3-octave keyboard. The KVP, the MS-20, none of it can really produce a pitch voltage that's outside of the 3-octave range. So just keep that in mind. First, we will be doing the volts per octave to hertz per volt calibration. I use the headphone output. I'm going to be monitoring the MS-20 signal in my zero scope here. I'm going to connect the channel 4 pitch CV over to the KVP. Volts per octave input here. And then I want to take hertz per volt output and run it over to the VCO 1 and 2 CV in. That's there. Of course, I'll need to convert the gate signal, so I'll send the channel 4 gate signal out of the Keystep Pro and into gate 1, and then gate 1 out over to the MS-20 trigger in. Of course, we're not going to hear anything unless we plug the zero scope out over to a mixer. Okay, so we're getting the signal from the Keystep Pro through KVP over to the MS-20 now. We want to have the VCO1 level up on the MS-20, but turn down all the way the VCO2 level. And we want to set the VCO1 to 16 foot, and that our master tune pitch is set where we want it. Of course, if you hit the keys on the MS-20 at this time, it won't do it because of the connection that we made to the trigger input. It will only listen to whatever the Keystep Pro is telling it to do. Now, since I'm triggering notes from the Keystep Pro, we want to set the envelope so it can stay open as long as it can. I'm triggering it from the Keystep Pro. And we want to open the filter all the way. That way we get a good clean frequency reading on our zero scope. We'll need to put the zero scope into frequency mode so that we can see what frequencies the MS-20 is spitting out. Okay, now I'm playing the lowest note on the BeatStep Pro, and you can hear that it is way out of whack. So, first we need to trim the frequency to C2. This is the note that I'm hitting right now. And once you get C2, then you'll want to play the highest note. C5 is what that needs to be. Okay, I'm hitting the C5 note, and I need to trim this. You'll need to go back and forth between C2 and C5 until you get it right. If you're ever in doubt in which note you should be getting out of the MS-20, you can play a note on your Keystep, then unplug it and play the same note on the MS-20. That's where it's supposed to be. Now we're going to calibrate the hertz per volt to volts per octave channel. I'll be using my 101 VCO. First, you'll just need to simply tune your oscillator. I'll run a pitch CV out and directly into my oscillator. You'll want to plug in that VCO to a frequency counter. And now when I play the lowest note on my Keystep Pro, I want it to say C1, so I'm just tuning my oscillators, all I'm doing. There we go. And I'll just let that drone. I won't worry about running the triggers or anything. Unplug the volts per octave input, because we are going to use the KVP. We are going to be sending our pitch signal from the MS-20 over here. So let's plug that in. Down MS-20, I'll use the keyboard CV out. The notes I'll be using this time for this calibration will be A and the highest C, C3. These two notes, okay? I have to set the frequency until I get A. There it is. Now on the MS-20, I have to hit the high C, and that one, I'm going to tune that to C3. And now I'll play the A again, and then keep dialing it in. It's an analog module, so you have to remember the synthesizer, the MS-20 is analog, this is an analog module, this is an analog module, the pitch isn't going to be absolutely perfect, but it will be very close, within a few cents or two, and then it will sound just fine. Now I'm playing the notes of the VCO, 101 VCO from the MS-20. That's how it's done.